Welcome to this channel, Talking Education. My name is Nyemba James, and I'm an academician. On this channel, I bring to you videos about education, mostly my lectures in different courses. And in the next video, I'm talking about sociology of education. This video, I did it when I was doing an online lecture with pastors at Twin Palm Leadership University. I was teaching them concepts in sociology of education when they were doing teaching methods. One of the things that you have to know is that these concepts in sociology of education can work in your ministry as a pastor. The same theories that teachers use are the same theories that can help you to do your ministry effective. If you want to see more of these videos, please subscribe to this channel so that whenever we upload a new video, you receive a notification. Please join me in the next lecture as I deal with sociology of education. Starting our class, let's start with the meaning of sociology. The meaning of sociology, so that we can build on this as we go on. Different scholars have defined sociology in different ways. That is where we can start from. So we'll borrow a number of definitions, maybe three or four definitions, so that we can understand and be able to know where we are going. So
recording in progress.
Okay, sorry, I was trying to record this Zoom meeting, so there's something that is I was saying we'll start by dealing with sociology, defining what sociology is, and then we'll stream it down. Probably we can also consider some few branches of sociology, if time will allow, that will take us into sociology of education. On this on the screen, you will see there is nature and scope of sociology of education. However, I'm starting from defining what is sociology, the meaning of sociology. I've already said that different scholars have defined sociology in different ways. There are so many definitions that scholars have given us what sociology is. I have gotten three or four definitions that, for the sake of this class, that we can apply. The first one, I've said that sociology is the scientific study of social interaction and the development of human social interaction. That is the first definition that I'm bringing to you, that this is a scientific study of social interaction and the development of human social interaction. So there are three things that we need to take note from this definition. One, scientific. I hear someone wants to ask a question, or it's some feedback of our class. Okay, I'm saying that the first definition here, I'm saying that sociology is the scientific study. So remember, everything that is scientific is a science. So we can even say that it's a science of social interaction. And everything that is a science, remember, that it has to pass an empirical evidence. It has to be logically proven. So, meaning the theories that are developed in sociology are theories that can be proven. They can be proven. Now, this scientific study is a study of social interaction, meaning how do people interact in the society. And also the third thing we are saying is the development of human social interaction. And how does this interaction develop of how people interact in their society? So that is the first definition. Now, let me also borrow the definition of Ezewu. The spelling is E-Z-E-W-U. E-Z-E-W-U. I think you are able to see it on your screen. It defined a sociology by saying that it is as a scientific study of human behavior in groups. Now, this is one of the definitions that I like. It simplifies it. It says that sociology is a scientific study of human behavior in groups. So meaning this is a study of how people behave now, not as individuals but as a group. Remember, there is a behavior of a group. I can give you an example. If you people look at Tongas, there is a given behavior that you know that this is how Tongas behave. This is how, so you are not looking at one person, probably maybe a Nyemba who is